Hello everybody, my name is Thrills and Gills, and welcome back. I have finally returned to the original style of videos I wanted to do. It's been a while. I have uploaded a lot of the things that have come in and out. But yeah, I'm back this time, and I promise these videos are gonna come out more often. It's just taken a long time to get here. So today we're going to talk about crayfish. As you can see, here is my electric blue crayfish. This is a male crayfish for specifics, and we will specifically just be talking about large crayfish. I believe dwarf crayfish are different enough to warrant their own video. So we'll just be talking about this guy. So, to my knowledge, this crayfish is about a year old. It is a fully grown adult. Crayfish of this nature, even if they're different colors like the fireball red, the ghost white, or just regular crawfish, most of them get around 4 to 6 inches. That's what you're gonna see. And then when you usually buy them, they're usually gonna be in at around 2 inches. So what should I know? Is it a good idea to have a crayfish? Well, we're gonna answer all of those questions. So first, are they hardy? Yes. They are very hardy animals. They are very difficult to kill. They don't get a lot of diseases. They can get some, such as crustacean shell rot, which can be very difficult to cure. It is unfortunately usually a death sentence if it occurs, but it's very rare to occur. And usually it's easy to prevent. The best way to prevent it is just make sure you have good water quality. But a big part of crayfish as well is, well, just how hardy they are. Since they're a crustacean, a lot of fish diseases obviously don't affect them because they don't have a lot of the issues that fish have, such as fins and normal gills. So they can handle a lot of that. And they're also known for eating detritus, so they kind of have to be a little bit hardier to handle that. So, what do they eat? Well, they'll eat just about anything. They're not picky in the slightest. They'll eat meat, they'll eat vegetable matter, they'll eat detritus, and usually you'll see them wandering around at night cleaning up whatever falls on the ground, whether that's fish droppings or wasted food. They'll clean it up. And very unfortunately, this is why you have to keep an eye on crayfish. And this is what I'm going to get into next, is they're also opportunistic predators. Now, you may be asking me, oh, so why do I have it in with all of my really pretty fish in my 75? Isn't it going to eat things? Well, there's a balance. First of all, yes, it is an opportunistic predator that will take advantage of fish, but it's not very good at it. It's built for grabbing detritus, and usually it only grabs fish that are a little too unwary of their surroundings, and it grabs them if they're off guard. So usually it's just not a good idea to put slow or very long finned fish in with it. So don't keep things like, I wouldn't keep any sort of nano fish with it. I wouldn't keep any small tetras with it. And definitely don't keep anything slow that would stick to the ground, like gobies, gudgeons, other crustaceans. That's the other big no-no. Can't have any other crustaceans with it. They will terrorize any other crustacean they find. They are territorial, and they will attack things that get too close to their face. And usually that's the way that most fish go if they get attacked, is they're in its face and it pinches the crap out of them. I even had that issue before. I didn't catch video of it, but my platinum tried messing with it and it pinched the crap out of it. They don't really bother each other now, though. Now, for specific species, this is specifically the Floridian Electric Blue, or the St. John's Blue. And as the name suggests, it's from the St. John's River in Florida. It is endemic to Florida, so it only comes from Florida. What else should I know about this crustacean? Well, don't keep other crayfish with it. That is the one tank mate you never put in with another crayfish. Now, dwarf crayfish, as I said, they're a little bit different, and we'll get to that later. But these guys, unless you want to have absolute war come into your tank, don't put another crayfish into it. One per tank. And as I said, as long as you have fast-moving fish that can learn to avoid the crayfish, you shouldn't have too many issues. Do I recommend them as a beginner pet? Yes and no. If you're not ready to deal with an animal that may try eating your other pets, I would stay away from it. But if you're willing to just keep it by itself, you have a very good chance to have a very hardy, very cool-looking pet. Environment-wise, lots and lots of caves. They don't really ask for much, but they need lots of caves. They want to hide. They like the dark. They like to stay in the shade. They don't like bright lights. So make sure, as you can see, there's lots of caves and assortments of different kinds that he can walk around and hide in. Other things that should be kept in mind. Crayfish are usually pretty active at night, and they do come out at day sometimes, but they usually come out at night. That's what they prefer. It's when they feel safe. And if you want to feed them more close to, like, nighttime. So, do I recommend these? Yeah, I do. Are they pricey? Some of them are. This guy specifically was around $28. So, that's decently expensive. But I would say that it's definitely worth your time if you want one. Oh, and I almost forgot. Super important. What size tank should I have? Now, because they don't move as often, some people have recommended you can have a 10-gallon tank for these guys. I personally do not recommend that. Now, the dwarf crayfish, go crazy if you want a 10-gallon tank. But for these guys, they are going to get huge, and they do like to move. They don't move super often because they move at night, but they do move. So I recommend at least a 20-gallon minimum. And as you can see, he's in a 75, so, yeah, it's to each their own, but personally, I'd say a 20-gallon tank is best with lots of rock work. Do they have a specific pH? In their natural habitat, I believe it is around a 7, but they have a very, very, easygoing parameters. They're pretty hardy with parameters and don't really mind it. So, yeah, I recommend it. Not very hard to take care of. Very pretty, very big. Just keep it away from other crustaceans. Make sure the fish you keep with it are big enough and fast enough to stay away from it. And you've got yourself a good pet. Now, next time, we'll be getting to some more complicated fish. But until then, I'll see you on the high tide. Bye!